अस्सलाम वालेकुम, आप सबका बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया कि आप अपना कीमती वक्त निकाल कर इस प्रोटेस्ट में शामिल हुए। तमाम भाइयों से दरख्वास्त है कि पार्क की लेफ्ट हैंड साइड पर चले जाएं, सामने आकर अपने बैनर और फ्लैग को
وَنَفْسٍ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنْفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ أُولَئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ وَأُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ صَدَقَ اللَّهُ الْعَظِيمُ.
I have recited the verses of the second chapter of the Holy Quran, Surah Baqarah, Ayat 153 to 157. It means, Allah says, O you who have believed, seek help through patience and prayer. Indeed, Allah is with the patient. And do not say about those who are killed in the way of Allah that they are dead. Rather, they are alive, but you perceive it not. And we will surely test you with something of fear and hunger and a loss of wealth and lives and fruits. But give glad tidings to the patient one, who, when disaster strikes them, say, indeed, we belong to Allah. And indeed, to him we shall return. To whom are the ones upon whom are blessings from the Lord and mercy. And it is those who are the rightly guided.
I have a warning. 但你们不知觉，我必以色美的恐怖和饥馑，以及资产、生命、收获等的损失，是业力，你将向坚忍的人报喜。他们足十困难的时候说：我们是真主所有的，我们必定只归依他。这等人是目中主的右座，这等人确是遵从神道的。
And hundreds have drowned in the sea, trying to flee the persecution. In the past few days, the world has witnessed horrific crimes against humanity committed by the Myanmar government. From burning villages of innocent Rohingya civilians, to raping helpless Rohingya girls, from shamelessly defending the barbaric mass murders, mass graves, and burned villages, under the cover of so-called security threat, to mercilessly blocking relief agencies from reaching the bruised and beaten Rohingya Muslims. From repeatedly blocking the United Nations investigation efforts to attempting the media censorship, Myanmar has not left any stone unturned in committing modern-day war crimes. Myanmar has proven to be an apartheid regime. But this violence and bigotry is not new. It is not even an isolated group of people who are committing this crime. This violation and discrimination has happened for decades and committed by the Myanmar government itself. There are two specific individuals that must be mentioned. The first is Nobel Peace Prize winner Aung San Suu Kyi, who has proven to be a selected peace worker. She has not just remained silent, but in fact encouraged violence by reiterating the powerful military's barbaric and discriminatory policies against the Rohingya. Aung San Suu Kyi, shame on you! Aung San Suu Kyi!
Shame on you!
Aung San Suu Kyi!
Shame on you!
Burmese military!
Shame on you!
Burmese government!
Shame on you!
She has made it clear that she does not consider Rohingya as humans, and it is perfectly fine for the Myanmar military and their mobs to commit these war crimes while she fulfills her duty to remain a puppet under the disguise of free peace prize worthy. We demand the Nobel Committee to revoke her award immediately or make their definition of peace clear to the world. If this award is not revoked by the committee, it will be evident to the world that the Nobel Committee and all other awardees of the Nobel Peace Prize share the same repressive and violent views as Aung San Suu Kyi. We also urge the two most recent awardees of the Nobel Peace Prize, former President of the United States Barack Obama and Pakistan's Malala Yousafzai, to return their awards if they really believe in peace. The second person worth mentioning is Ashin Biratu, the terrorist leader and hate preacher disguised as a religious leader in Myanmar. His hate speech and other violent activities are completely contrary to his religion. Yet, he enjoys extremist support by armed militia, moves freely, and commits his treacherous plans with impunity in Myanmar. We demand the Myanmar government and international community to arrest him immediately and ensure due process in international criminal court. Moreover, we appeal to our government of the Hong Kong Special Administrative Region of China to proactively push the government of Myanmar to immediately stop this horrific genocide.